what was discussed there and if you had any one-on-one conversations with him as well.
Well, that was intended to be a private meeting between the president and governors, and I want to make sure I keep the trust of both those that were in that room, just like I do all of our citizens. I don't mind telling you what I said. I said that our president is known for being a straight talker, telling the American people the truth, and my recommendation was that he have an open conversation with the public about the status of his health. For those that are worried, addressing it directly, I think, could be really beneficial.
There have been rumors swirling around with your name being brought up and about the Democratic National Convention. Do you plan on attending there? What do you make of the rumors?
Well, I'm a delegate to the Democratic National Convention. I was going before. I'm going now. Now, Joe Biden is the nominee. The only way that's not the case is if he decides he's not going to pursue the nomination. My name being brought up, I don't hear that as me. I hear that as us. What's going on in Kentucky is really exciting. We have a cloud of pessimism hanging over our country and this feeling of optimism throughout Kentucky with the record jobs, breaking the record on exports, record tourism, low recidivism, our overdose deaths going down 2 years in a row. They're just really good things going on in Kentucky, and they're not red and they're not blue. They're just good for everybody. So I think when you hear my name floated, it's because people see what we all are doing, and they long for a world where we can get past the constant back and forth and just move forward together.
Are you going to be speaking at the convention?
If they put out those invites, I don't know about it. So,
as you said, he has to choose not to run again. You've said during your reelection campaign, and even since you were reelected, that you would serve out your full term. Is that still how you feel with all the speculation as you potential VP if he steps down?
I love being governor of the Commonwealth of Kentucky. I plan on continuing to be governor of the Commonwealth of Kentucky. I'm not going to speculate on this, is he running or is he not, because he says he's running. The only way I would ever consider anything other than this job, which I love, is if I felt that I could help this Commonwealth in special and important ways.
Governor, do you feel more confident about the president's health after that meeting with him?
Well, the president was in control of the room. He answered questions for an hour, but it's not about me. It's about the American people, and this is the president of the United States. So my hope is he'll come forward, and he'll just do what he has done throughout his career. He'll talk plainly and directly to the American people about his health. And we in the South talk about our health all the time. You see somebody, you say, how are you doing? And you get about 10 minutes. Sometimes they even pull out their lab results and talk through the numbers with you. So I think for a large part of America, this is something that we're used to, and we just want to hear from him.
Is that something that's a big concern for the constituents you hear from, that his health is something that's top of mind for them?
Oh, yes. I believe that you run towards problems, not away from them. There's no question the president took a hit in that debate and that people are worried about his health and want to hear directly from him. I got to see him, you know, in a meeting, in control of the room, answering all those questions. But again, it's not about me. He is the president of the United States and needs to be able to speak to all those citizens directly about it.
One more, guys.
Noting you said that he commanded the room, he was in charge of the room. Did you notice a difference, to kind of reiterate this, in his mental acuity on Wednesday when you were there in person versus, you know, when he visited Kentucky in January of last year over Brent Spence?
Well, I think the president was answering questions from 11 or 12 governors, and we tend to ask difficult questions. He asked for really candid advice and responded to it. So I thought that the president certainly engaged with us on complicated matters. But again, this is something that he needs to not just reassure Democratic governors on, but he needs to reassure the American people.
Thanks, guys.